be blessed by the divine. May the whole world enjoy prosperity, happiness, and peace. Dear sky meditators, I am very happy to welcome all of you to the spiritual session in English organized by the World Community Service Center IT team. Our Guru Yogiraj Vedatri Maharshi says that when one is silent, God talks to him. Maunam, the silence, does not mean mere observance of silence, but complete restfulness and awareness in thought, word, and deed. To explain this in detail, we have beloved senior professor K.R. Muniratnam sir from Chennai today. Sir holds an M.Com degree and M.Sc. in Yoga for Human Excellence. From the year 1989, sir is associated with WCSC and rendering his divine service as a professor since 1994. Sir is propagating the philosophy of our Guru to the seekers of various sectors, including World's University, SRM University, Bharat University, Savita Engineering College, Jain Engineering College, TCS, Exaware, etc. We have such an eminent professor for us today. On behalf of all, I invite our beloved senior professor, K.R. Muniratnam sir, to deliver his speech on the topic, Maunam, the Silence. Be blessed by the divine.
வாழ்க வையகம், வாழ்க வையகம், வாழ்க வளமுடன். குரு வாழ்க, குருவே துணை. Pranams to our Guru Vedatri Maharshi. My pranams to all the members who are assembled in this satsang now. எவர் ஒருவர் குருவை மதித்து ஒழுகினாலும் தப்பாது குரு உயர்வு மதிப்போதம்மை தரத்தில் உயர்த்தி பிறவி பயனை நல்கும். வாழ்க வளமுடன். In today's session, we are going to share our thoughts on the topic, the silence or the maunam. Swamiji used to observe maunam for 1 month continuously. Say starting from November 25th to December 25th, followed by master course. So in 1989, I had the opportunity. I went to RER. I attended and joined our Swamiji in Maunam for 3 days. And then followed by the master course. Of course, it is a wonderful occasion, wonderful experience. When I was observing Maunam with Swamiji, though I'm not knowing that much in those days, but the vibration I felt entirely, it will have a different magnetic field when we sit with Swamiji. So Swamiji will be coming to the classes, but no talk will be there. Everything will be scheduled. They will put in a board. And daily some 4 to 5 meditations will be going. And during the Mauna period, Swamiji used to share his revelations or intuitions with the members who are participating in that Mauna along with him. So all his intuitions will be written in the blackboard, placed in the classroom. We used to note it down. Really, it was an excellent experience. And then subsequently, whenever we had the opportunity to attend his classes and taking his health into consideration, some of the other professors will be taking the classes in the beginning, 5 to 10 minutes, they'll be talking about the topic. Then Swamiji used to summarize. So in that action, I need to notice one important thing, because after the professor has spoken on the topic, when Swamiji used to summarize, he will not point out that the professor has left out these things, these points. He will not mention at all. But when he was summarizing, Swamiji used to cover all the points. definitely we cannot differentiate. So the professor has left over these points, only Swami just covered. So this difference we will not notice at all. In such a manner, Swami used to cover all those points. So after some time, say after some 4 or 5 years, I felt the difference because, see, when a person is in a position to observe others, in short, we used to say, just keep your eyes and ears open. We can get so many things we can receive, that is, our receptivity will be increased. That experience I had. So to say, as far as the Maunam is concerned, the two, the spiritual followers like us, it's very much needed. Swami has given the importance, how to observe the silence, when to observe. Okay, when you observe the silence, what are the things to be done? How you can get it improved? So you are doing the meditation, along with it, when you do this Maunam also, the Maunam will help you to do the meditation in the right manner. You can go in deep. So in other words, this Maunam is an exercise for the mind. In Tamil, used to say Swamiji, Pesa non vanbadu verum vai moodal alla periya marai porulam manadai ariyum aaive. It is an exercise for the mind. So instead of the mind extended outside and contacting the other objects, enjoying it during the Maunam, it's being turned inside. That's called dive in, to know the divine power. So in yoga, spirituality motivated silence is called Maunam. That's the word. In fact, by doing this Mauna, Swamiji has given so many benefits. The prime one is, it will improve our attitude of receptivity. That means that receptivity power will be improved. And moreover, by observing Maunam, it will improve our concentration also. And as well as, it will keep us away from unwanted distractions. So before going to the deep in the topic, first let us understand what is Mauna or silence. See, Mauna means it's not like not talking, not like something like that. See, Mauna means it is an exercise, a research-oriented exercise for the mind to understand what is the absolute space. What are the connection between the space, absolute space, and the human beings? So likewise, say you would have seen in some families, say after a quarrel between the life partners, husband and wife, you would have observed, you would have seen. So they will not be talking for 2 to 3 months after the quarrel. It is not Mauna. In fact, the wife will tell proudly to others, see, I'm not talking with my husband for the past 3 months. So probably used to say, the same manner the husband also used to say that. So it is not Mauna. And as well as, let us understand that not talking is Mauna. It is something different, that is, our mind is focused towards the absolute space. We are in a position to understand what is absolute space, that is plenum or God, how it is connected with us. This can be understood only when we observe silence. Moreover, when we are going on talking, it will reduce our vital energy. Let us understand some of important points while observing the Mauna. When we are in silence, that is Maunam, we can recognize and understand divine thoughts. When we are immersed in divine thoughts, after stopping our talking, then we will realize talking is utter waste. We are losing our energy, not only our energy, in no way we are going to change others. So the first point, the prime point is, we should understand ourselves. It is for this reason that spiritual sages and saints, those who were living in those days, after some time, they will stop talking at all. Of course, they will write poems and articles. but it will stop talking, because only by such action they achieved liberation by practicing mauna, it was told. So slowly they will forget to talk. So keeping all these things in our mind, let us see . So maunam is a penance. That means it's also meditation, but it is entirely different from meditation, because meditation is an exercise for the consciousness, whereas this maunam is an exercise for the mind. So we are not letting out the mind, going outside and contact the other things and receiving unwanted imprints. Here when we observe mauna, definitely we are giving practice for the mind not to indulge in unwanted activities. So for that, we can choose the time to observe maunas. We can set aside just 1 or 2 hours or a specific time for the practice of mauna. If not possible daily, at least once in a week, in the weekend. The only thing we have to do is, before sitting in mauna, you have to inform your family, friends, not to disturb you. So they should make to understand that you are going to observe mauna. And moreover, you have to choose the place in your house. There should not be any distraction. So before observing mauna, when we follow all these things, definitely we can fully involve in observing the mauna, and moreover, it will give good results. And then it is a practice to control the mind. In fact, instead of putting the word control, we can change it to, it is a practice to understand the mind. Because as Swami said, it is not possible to control the mind. But whereas when you try to understand the mind will be under your control. So it is a practice to understand the mind. Then it is a practice that helps cleanse the mind. So the cleaning process, so as far as the mind is concerned, what is the need? Because the thoughts are being produced by the mind. When the mind is in the disturbed state or aggressive mood, definitely the thoughts produced by the mind definitely lead to problem. So what Swamiji said, to cleanse the mind, when you observe this mauna then and there, then definitely it will clean your mind, followed by whatever thought force emanating from the mind, definitely it will help not only you, but all the people surrounding you. So it is a practice that helps cleanse the mind. So Swamiji, in a wonderful poem, has expressed everything about this mauna. The imprints born of habits, that's a major point. So whatever you do, it's borrowed by the habits. Of course, habit means not only all bad habits, good habits are also there. But as far as the imprints are concerned, it's being followed by the habits. Only because of the habits, we get the imprints. It clashes with the consciousness, the supreme power, in their attempts to disturb the practice of mauna. So what Swamiji says, when we start observing mauna, the previous habits, which already have in our genetic center, it will try to disturb us not to follow the mauna or complete the mauna. It happens for anybody for that matter. So when we are sitting idle, the number of thought posts will be very less. It would absorb. When we are going to do the meditation, then lot of thought force will be emanating. It will be disturbing you. We can't continue the meditation at all. It happens. We have experienced. So when we start doing this, when we start to observe the mauna, the habits already being imprinted in our genetic center, it will clash with our consciousness and it will attempt to disturb the practice of mauna. It happens. But to follow the sadhana marga, so we should not take all this into consideration. We should practice to observe mauna whenever we get the time and break the silence. Maunam is a great practice that provides an opportunity to realize the self. So it is an opportunity to realize the self only. So once again, I repeat, just I want to emphasize, whether it is meditation or mauna, though both are different, by practicing these things,
we are in a position to understand self. We can realize self. When we realize self, it will be very easy for us to understand the supreme power. And followed by, whenever you understand the supreme power, we come to a conclusion that everything is the source of all forces is the supreme power. When we understand this, definitely what happens? We will not hurt others by our action, whether it is word or deed. We will not hurt others. And secondary, even if somebody is suffering, definitely we will extend our help. So Mounam is a great practice that provides an opportunity to realize the self and nature. That's very important. So we are understanding not only self, but also the nature, the supreme power, the absolute space, the planum, God, whatever you give the name, as well as the relationship between the two. So once again, I repeat. So when we observe Mauna, we will be in a position to understand not only self, but also the nature. So when we are in a position to understand the relationship between these two, then definitely it will help us to lead a peaceful life. That is the prime motto of this yoga itself. And it is not mere silence. It's the excellent word. That's what Swamiji used to say. Pesa non mambadu verum vai mudal alla. It is not mere silence. It is a part of the quest for the imperceptibles. Excellent words. That quest means, what do you mean by quest? A long search for something which is difficult to find. That is a quest. That is supreme power. So it's very difficult to see with the senses. So when we are trying to see the plenum or absolute space with the senses, definitely we can't see. It cannot be seen. So for the impulse, because it's very tiny one, it's very small one, we can't see it with the senses. Whereas through the mind, when it's going to the subtle level, so that we can understand what is God, what is plenum, and what is absolute space, and what is the relationship between the absolute space and the mind. That's why it said, Brahman is primarily the supreme silence. So the language of the God is silence. So when we want to talk with the God, only through the silence we can talk with the God. That is the ultimate philosophy. So unless we stop our talking and observe silence, the words from the God, we will not be positioned to hear. We used to say, is it not? Naam pesada podu iraivan pesugindra. So when if you want to hear the words from the God, first we should stop talking. We should observe silence, because the silence the Brahman is the primarily the supreme silence itself. The peace of the mind is silence. And moreover, silence is the deep language of the heart. That's why it's told here. It is a part of the quest. So these are all the things we can get in our mind when we observe silence. That's very important. So in short, the purpose of observing silence is to understand the mind, to understand the self, and to understand the supreme power. When we are in a position to understand the supreme power, automatically we will be in a position to understand the mind, why it is wavering or wandering here and there, why it is very much indulged in the sensory enjoyment, what is the reason. So when we are indulging in the sensory enjoyments, what happens? Our biomagnetism is consumed through the senses. This biomagnetism is being produced by the life force. The life force, its origin is the supreme power. So in short, by consuming this life force only, that energy only, we are enjoying the world. When it is being crossed, when we cross the limit, so whatever so far we were enjoying, it will be resulted in the agony or miseries or illness. So this is the excellent philosophy Swamiji has given. And each man who sincerely aspires to know God must previously know this stillness, which one? The stillness of the supreme power. Next. So there are three types of Mounam. Swamiji used to give the explanation. First one is abstain from talk. And second one is from actions. third one Mahamona, the first two are included. So as far as the Monam, Swamiji has taught to us, the third one, that is Mahamonam. When we observe this Mahamonam, it is a practice, research oriented practice for the mind. When we practice this Mahamonam, what happens? Definitely, we will not talk. And moreover, we will not lose our limbs. So these two things are imbibed in this Mahamona, because when we do this Mahamona, the Monam by for the mind, automatically these two things, it will be covered in this. So here, Swamiji has given these three types, that is abstain from talk. Even while we observe Monam, we are not showing action at all. So we have to first get rid of that. And second one, we are not to whisper. See, talking loudly is not only talking, but also whispering also is talking only. And using limbs, it's not allowed. So as far as the Mahamaunam is concerned, it is a practice for the mind. What will happen? You can get communicate with the body language so that you can practice Maunam whilst following your worldly life. It will give a great meditation. It's kind of, it's sort of meditation. But once again, I repeat, meditation is entirely different from Maunam. Then when we practice Maunam, develop a calm mind and reach the divine. That's the process. You will become mature and receive permanent bliss through this Maunam. These are the benefits. Forget everything. Don't think about anything. Of course, there are so many philosophies are there. So when we observe Maunam, no thought force should be emanating. This one philosophy. But whereas what Swamiji said, we can't observe Maunam without any thought force. But only thing is, that thought force should be directed towards the absolute space. That thought force will be there. We can't get rid of it. But whereas when we are focusing the mind on the absolute space, definitely you will get reap the benefits of Mauna. Close your eyes and be without observing anything. Say we can do introspection. We can bless the people. This will bring about a permanent spiritual state of bliss. So that's all the benefits. And that is a sadhana in those days the sages were doing. So let me repeat, in those days, the saints, the sages, after some time, they will stop talking. So they know. So by talking, nothing can be done. So instead of that, they used to write the articles, their revelations, their findings, their intuitions, everything will come out in a form of poem or articles. The same thing Swamiji did. So while he was observing the Mauna, it was for 30 days, daily some kind of poems about the philosophy. It may be magnetism, it may be cause and effect theory or karma theory, or it may be the evolution of living things, or it may be about the family peace. Everything will be there. So everything he will bring out by means of a poem or article. So next one, the greatness of Maunam, let us understand. It helps eradication of three impurities. So what are the impurities? Sinful imprints, ego and maya. So we can come out of it. So the three impurities, because during the Mauna, we are directing our thought force towards understanding the self. So we are trying to understand the self. Definitely we'll come to in a position there to understand what is ego, what is sinful imprint, and what is maya. So by practice this Mauna, automatically, slowly and gradually, we'll come out of this sinful imprints. So this is the first step towards attaining the primordial state or absolute space. And second one, attain spiritual emancipation, that is liberation. And third, attain clarity of thoughts and equanimity of mind. So these things are possible. So by doing this Maunam, definitely we can reap all these benefits. And moreover, the Maunam develops willpower. And also it helps in respecting the truth. In some cases, when we are in a position to understand self, it will help us to control our anger also. See, after completion of the maunam, of course, we have to move with our family members only. But after the mauna, most of the people used to say, definitely they will be reduced their talking. They will feel, see, it's a waste of talking. They will feel like that. And some of the people, they end up prepared to hear more sound after completion of the mauna. And then it will improve the power of endurance. And moreover, even at times, it may cure some sort of psychosomatic diseases. These are the benefits we derive by doing this mauna. And then achieve the purpose of birth. So let us understand, what is the purpose of birth? To understand, to understand and realize self, and as well as to realize the God, the supreme power. So that's the purpose of life. So this can be achieved by observing mauna whenever you find time. And let us see some more benefits of the mauna. Ability to regulate the senses. Yes. See, when we observe mauna, as I told you, instead of the mind being having contact with the outer world and having enjoyments through the sensory organs, when it observes mauna, it understands that we are losing our biomagnetism. In turn, in short, we can say we are losing our life force, life energy. Only by consuming our life energy, we are enjoying so many things. So when we understand this, definitely we will be in a position to regulate the senses. First one. Next, God realization during meditation. Yes, when we observe this mauna, it will help you to do meditation in a proper manner. Moreover, you can go in depth. So you can concentrate more. Attain perfection. So perfection means in all respects. That is self-realization, understanding others, maintaining harmony between self and others, and as well as maintaining harmony within ourselves, inner harmony or inner peace. All things will be possible by doing this mauna. Achieve spiritual progress. So day by day, when we are joining this spiritual organization, so along with this, meditation and introspection, when we do this mauna, definitely we can see the progress, spiritual progress. And moreover, in short, we can say it will increase our spiritual quotient. The desire to render service increases. So when we are in the position to understand self, in Tamil we used to say, is it not? Arindhadu Sivam, Malandhadu Anbu. So when we understood God, we come to a conclusion that everything is being incarnated by the God. So when I hurt others, I'm hurting the God. When I realize this, definitely I will not hurt others. And moreover, if anybody is suffering, I will render help. So the desire to render service increases. The secrets of universe stands revealed through intuition. So we will be in a position to understand what is nature, what is God, what is supreme being, how the primordial state through its inherent force and consciousness being produced by the atoms, then molecules, then panchabhutas, then living things, the human being. In the human being, how this absolute space functions as mind. So what is the relationship between the mind and the absolute space? All things we will be in a position to understand. So that's what it's told as, the secrets of the universe stands revealed with the help of our mind. So the greatness of mauna, let us understand, the greatness of mauna cannot be described in mere words. That means we have to practice. We have to practice. It's sadhana marg. Silence is the root of the consciousness. It exists beyond the realms of space and time. So there is no limit for it. So my friends, as Swamiji has given the importance of this mauna, let us spare our time. It is up to us. The time management, it is within our purview. So let us set aside 1 or 2 hours at a specific time in a week or in the weekend or once in a month. Let us do this. Let us practice. Let us observe this maunam. And before sitting for the maunam, let us inform our family members if we do maunam in at home. And many places we used to observe maunam in the mandrams. We choose a particular day. It's a good choice. because along with others we can do the maunam, and moreover choose a place without any distraction, so it will help us to realize not only self but also God, the supreme power. So to say, in nutshell, when we practice this mauna, we will be in a position to understand self and the supreme power, which will help us to lead a peaceful life. With these words, let me conclude this topic on maunam, the silence. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. By the grace of divine, you may all enjoy good health, long life, enough health, prosperity, wisdom, and peace. Be blessed by the divine. May the whole world enjoy happiness, peace, and prosperity. Be blessed by divine. Vaazhga Valamudan. Vaazhga Valamudan. Thank you all for the opportunity. Vaazhga Valamudan.
Vaazhga Valamudan. Thank you very much, sir, for the excellent speech today. You have beautifully explained that maunam is a proper psychic practice for streamlining the mind. It is a journey of consciousness towards the unified force. Further, you have listed out various benefits achieved through maunam, as explained by our guru, and I am sure our sky meditators will regularly practice maunam hereafter if they are not doing till now, because the benefits that our professor has listed out today really makes all of us to practice maunam on a regular basis. Thank you very much, sir. Now the forum is open for discussions. Please click the raise hand button in your Zoom app to ask your questions. While you get ready with the questions, we have some important announcements to make. Practice kayakalpa yoga regularly and improve your immunity system, especially during this COVID time. If not yet learned kayakalpa yoga, please visit kayakalpayoga.edu.in or download the Android app. Please also recommend it to your friends and relatives and ask them to practice kayakalpa regularly. Our monthly journal Anbuli is also available in the Android app. Download the Anbuli app from the Android Play Store and get access to the premium content of our Swamiji speeches. As you may be aware, we are daily uploading rare videos of our guru. Today we have uploaded speech on the topic eradication of worries by our guru. Connect with us on Facebook and YouTube at Sky Yoga TV channel to listen to all the past speeches of our professors on various aspects of Sky Yoga. Karma Yoga principles of Vedatriyam suggest donating 1% of our income to the good causes of society. Be generous and donate to the World Community Service Center. There are multiple channels to do that, either through the Anbuli app or through our official websites, vedatri.edu.in and kundaliniyoga.edu.in. Just to mention, you would get Section 80G IT exemption as well for these donations. As many of you are aware, we have started online education through kundaliniyoga.edu.in. Please visit the website and know the details. Now let us move on to the question answer session. Bhuvaneshwari ma'am, please unmute yourself.
I am from Bangalore. You have given an excellent speech at the right time. Actually, I am also practicing maunam. I just want to know how you practice maunam, sir.
Generally, we used to observe maunam in mantras, madam. Now, in this period...
In this critical period, we used to observe
maunam then and there, but not continuously. Say, for example, half an hour or 1 hour, 2 hours, something like that. Once in a week. So, okay. I used to observe, but it depends. It depends.
But how to practice at home, sir?
At home, see, you just sit in a comfortable place. You can do introspection, or you can think about the absolute space. So just sit silently, and your thought force to be directed towards the absolute space.
How much minutes I should do, sir?
1 minute, 1 hour, 1.5 hours, 2 hours.
1 hour, is it I should specify the time every day, the same time I should follow?
It is up to you only. There is no hard and fast rule given by Swamiji. Okay. It is up to us. Okay.
is according to your convenience. No problem.
Thank you so much, sir. Valgam.
So nice.
Valgam. Sesachalam sir, please unmute yourself, sir.
Sir, Valga Valamudan.
Valga Valamudan.
Sir, you have given an extraordinary explanation on Mauna.
Thank you.
Actually, what the questions which I was planning to ask you, but Bhuvaneshwari madam has asked.
Okay.
But the thing is that suppose if we are even sitting close to our eyes and say it for 1 hour, is it advisable to read any books or listen any Swamiji speech during the Maunams?
No. It's not advisable to hear Swamiji speech. That's what Swamiji told. You just keep silent. Okay.
So that means, suppose if I am planning for 1 hour sitting, I should only sit and concentrate on some.
You can do introspection. You can do blessings. You can do blessings.
I can use pencil and paper for any reasons.
No. Swamiji didn't say like that.
So nothing I should do.
Yes.
Suppose if I want to make a remark, something how to maintain.
That the observe Maunam, what Swamiji say. So let us not use anything. Using pencil or something like that. It's not necessary. You just keep your eyes closed and focus the mind on its origin. That's all.
Then one more question: that this silence has to be followed only by sitting or on this chair or sit on the floor.
Your convenience.
Or,
no problem. Your convenience. Your convenience.
Or that's lying on the bed.
No. Your convenience only.
So sitting on the chair or sitting on the floor should be preferable.
Yes. You can. No problem.
No. The why I am asking this question is actually I went for a Maunam in Perur, Coimbatore.
Okay.
So on that day they have given some kind of speech also. So that is the reason I got a query on.
For example, some of the people they are comfortable sitting in Sukhasana on the chair or on the floor, but somebody they could not sit on the floor. They prefer only the chairs because if you ask them to sit in Sukhasana, their attention will be diverted.
Okay.
So they can't sit for a long time, isn't it? So that's why it is up to you. According to your convenience, you can sit either on the floor or on the chair. Even sometimes, say when you are doing this Maunam, say for half an hour you are sitting on the floor, you find it very difficult to continue sitting in the floor. You can change your position. No problem at all.
Okay.
Thank you.
But is it advisable to be in the Maunam by closing the eyes only?
Not like that, because when you open the eyes, you will be distracted. That's why.
Okay. So that means closing the eyes is
better. It's better.
Better.
Yeah.
Excellent, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Ganesh Rao, sir, please unmute yourself.
Valka Vayakam, Valka Vallamudan. Ayya. அற்புதமா பேசுறீங்க நிறைய அற்புதமான யூ ஹவ் கிவன் லாட் ஆஃப் எக்ஸலன்ட் ஐடியாஸ் மௌனம் அபவுட் மௌனம் அண்ட் மை க்வெஸ்சன் டு யூ இஸ் இன் த டொமஸ்டிக் குவாரல் பிட்வீன் த ஹவுஸ் அண்ட் ஹவுஸ் ஒய்ஃப் அண்ட் ஹஸ்பண்ட் விச் வே திஸ் மௌனம் ஹெல்ப்ஸ் ஆர் இந்த மௌனம் வாட் த ஹஸ்பண்ட் ஆர் ஒய்ஃப் வாட் தே ஷுட் டு
சிம்பிள் சார் as Swamiji told see during the mauna we are trying to understand not only self but also wife. Isn't it? So after observing a mauna, see during the mauna, you just bless both of us, husband, wife, you bless both of you. Then after completing the mauna, see during the mauna, what happens? You are trying to understand the attitude of your wife, or wife, the husband. So definitely, you are trying to understand, you are trying to accept as she is or as he is. So it will solve the problems between you. Moreover, when you observe Mauna, both of you will come out of the ego. So any one of you can extend your arm. You will be in a position to, what you say, apologize or say sorry. These things will solve the problems. Because instead of aggravating the issues between them, by observing this Mauna, it gives you a way to understand each other. Then you can come out of unwanted agony among you. This is the principle Swamiji has uttered. Valga Valamudan.
Valga Valamudan. Arulindi Ramasamy sir, please unmute sir.
Sir, I am Ramasamy from Maripakam sir.
Yes.
Sir, Maunam is very, very useful sir. My question is sir, you have mentioned the three types of Maunam. That is abstain from talk,
yes.
Abstain from action.
Yes.
Sir, the talking stage comes only after thinking sir. என்னமல்ல நிலையே மௌனம் சொல்லிட்டு தான் I have understood.
You are right. Say in Tamil it's called as கரி மௌனம் வாக்கு மௌனம் மகா மௌனம். Okay, if you see எண்ணம் வருது இல்லைன்னு சொல்ல வரல, பட் இன் மௌனம் வாட் வி டூ there will be thought force, but it will be focused towards the absolute space. இறைவனை நோக்கிய எண்ணமாக இருக்கும், தவறு கிடையாது. வாழ்க வளமுடன்.
Okay, this is one more question sir.
உமாசங்கர் சார் பிளீஸ் அன்மியூட் யுவர்செல்ஃப் வாழ்க வளமுடன் சார் உமாசங்கர் ஃப்ரம் பெங்களூர்
Yeah. Actually, I'm doing this Sky Meditation joined of 7-8 years back, or later I discontinued. But recently, after hearing all these things in your program, it got very much useful to me. And particularly Maunam, I just attended lately. But my thing is, I'm not doing the meditation because I lost the Agna, this thing and all, no touch. So since this COVID thing,
yeah,
I'm doing all the other Sky exercises and Kayakalpa and all. Actually, my question is, during Maunam, can we do meditation or Maunam is different, meditation is different?
Meditation is different, sir. As Swamiji, what he said, as far as the meditation is concerned, we are giving practice for the consciousness.
Okay.
That is, it's an exercise for the consciousness. Whereas in Mauna, it is a practice for the mind. Both are different.
Okay, I can do Maunam, sir, now?
Yeah. You can do.
Okay. But no action.
Mantras, so that you can do Maunam also.
Okay. In the house only, I can sit one place and do it as per you, sir, your suggestion.
Exactly.
Thank you very much, sir. Valgavalam.
Thank you, sir. Aruna, madam, please unmute yourself. Aruna, ma'am, you have to unmute at your end, ma'am. Okay, Brahma Ramba, ma'am, please unmute yourself.
Valaga Valamudan, sir.
Valaga
Valamudan. I am Brahma Ramba from Hosur.
Yeah.
While doing Mauna, you are advising to close your eyes. If you are there, is it possible?
Both are talking. Okay.
Hello.
I ask you to close the eyes. Proceed.
Yeah. You are advising to close your eyes while observing Mauna.
Okay.
If you observe more than 2-3 hours or entire day, is it possible?
No, it is not possible. See, the reply is given to that person. See, what you asked, whether it is, we have to keep your eyes closed continuously. Then what I told him, see, if you open the eyes, you will be distracted. So here you are asking, if you close your eyes for more than 2-3 hours, it is not possible. So then you have to open the eyes, no problem at all. But only thing is, your attention should not be diverted. You have to take care of that. That's all.
Valga Valamudan. Nalini, madam, please unmute yourself.
Valga Samradhyandike, sir.
Tell me, madam. Valga Valamudan.
I'm calling from Bangalore. Yeah. Wonderful talk on Mauna, sir.
Thank you.
It is. And one question I have.
Yeah.
While explaining the benefit of Mauna, you said it relates to the truth.
Yeah.
Will you explain a bit little, sir?
I think the truth is absolute space, God. Regarding God, that is the truth, isn't it? So always the truth is the best.
Okay.
What Swamiji said, that truth will be always the truth, whether it is yesterday or today or tomorrow. The truth is truth. So the truth here is the absolute space, the God. Be blessed.
Thank you, sir. Be blessed by the divine. And dear Sky Meditators, it's now time for us to express our gratitude to our professor who have patiently answered all our questions and sharing his insights and divine thoughts. please come to meditative position and keep your mind at Durya Chakra. Senior Professor K.R. Muniratnam sir, be blessed by the divine. His good health, be blessed by the divine. His loving family, be blessed by the divine. His divine service, be blessed by the divine. We would like to extend our blessings to the Sky Meditators for their kind donations made yesterday. Your generous donations will help us a long way to serve the society. By the grace of divine, may you and your family enjoy good health, long life, enough wealth, peace, prosperity, and wisdom. We are happy to bring the following online programs live from Alia Temple of Consciousness tomorrow. Morning 6 a.m. exercises in Tamil, 7 a.m. 9 center meditation in Tamil, 7:30 a.m. 9 center meditation in English, and tomorrow morning 11 a.m. there is speech in Tamil on the topic Noikku Idam Kodel by Senior Professor Thirunavukar sir from Udumalai. Evening 6 p.m. Duryatita meditation in Tamil, 7:30 p.m. Duryatita meditation in Telugu, and by 7:55 p.m. there is a speech in Telugu on the topic Eradication of Worries by Professor M.K. Nagamani ma'am from Vijayawada. Please share the program invite with your friends and relatives. Let everyone take part in this spiritual journey and get benefited. We thank our beloved President Arulnidhi Padmashri S.K. Mailanandan sir for his leadership and guidance. See you all tomorrow with another interesting session. Till then, be safe, practice our Kundalini Yoga. This is Ramesh from the All-Year World Community Service Center IT team. Be blessed by the divine. Good night.